Absolutely.
Probably don't have to do it.
Probably. All right, I can hear me.
No, no, there's another mic. There's another mic.
Try plugging in and see if you can hear me through that. Can you hear me? Yeah, can like, right. Something.
Oh, there's me. You just click me.
Okay. I'm back. I bet that did it.
Can you hear me?
That's why I bring you along. All right, now all we got to do is figure out the score, the plus six.
But I can't hear. I can't hear you.
Really? Sums up. I hear you great.
See about the other one. I bet I have to use the other one of those splitters too.
Yeah, that just cut me out.
Here, hold up.
All right, I'm trying to get out your way.
Uh-oh, now I can hear.
It's a working.
It's a little loud, though.
That's all right, I can deal with that. All right, hit plus six for TDs. Do I just hit a plus and a six?
Is it a touch screen here? Nope.
No, it's live, Bobby. We're trying to figure shit out.
Oh, is it live? Are we streaming now?
Well, the Lee Academy coach.
All right, it's not green.
The MAIS recognized that the spirit of the game of football lives in skilled offense, effective defense, and a well-planned strategy. The spirit of this game cannot be maintained unless sportsmanship, ethics, and integrity are our number one priority. Good sportsmanship will be expected from all groups associated with MAIS activity. Captain Fulton, Delta Street Lions will be number 61, Ty McGee. For Lee Academy, be number 14, Grady Burke. Number 55, Bo Lutzer. And number 67, Cason Barringer. The Academy has won the toss and deferred to the second half. Here comes the coach. Would everyone please stand for the prayer and continue to stand for the national anthem. Our gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for Jesus. Watch over these players tonight and protect them. In your Son's holy name I pray. Amen.
Good evening, Colt Nation. Coming at you on a Tuesday night here. We got the Lee Academy Colts going to be taking on Delta Streets from Greenwood, Mississippi.
I think that's probably the first meeting for our junior high in the Delta Streets.
I believe it is. We played in varsity a couple weeks ago. Lee won the toss, deferred to the second half. Delta Streets will be receiving the kickoff. Right, got a beautiful night. I think they rescheduled. We got some weather that's coming in Thursday, and they didn't want to chance it.
Yeah. Not a large crowd tonight.
No?
I don't think we're going to break any attendance records or anything.
Probably not. Not like the Rebels did this past weekend. Noah's getting it pegged up right now.
Kicking off of the Academy, be number 7, Noah Lindley.
And we're about ready to play. Short kind of kick, up through his legs, picked up, running opposite side, and gets taken down right there. Looks about the 18, 17-yard line.
Looks like it. Looks like Patrick Burton on that tackle.
Brought down by 22, Patrick Burton.
All right.
Be first and 10 line.
On an injury note, I know Monix is the only one, looks like, not playing tonight.
Yeah, he is. He is definitely not in his uniform this evening. I hope we wish him a very speedy recovery.
It looks like he's going to be okay.
Good. All right, they're coming to the line. Get a good look at the Lee Academy defense starting out here. Little quarterback keeper pass to the right on the flats and incomplete. Just little overthrew him.
Pass intended for number 10, Thomas, incomplete.
Who was that on coverage? Couldn't quite see. 37?
On the coverage for Lee Academy,
looks like
number 33.
Stratton Dunn. One of the good golfers on the golf team. Let's see. All right, they're kind of taking their time at the huddle. Here they come to the line.
Got that same two receiver set.
Yep. 10, number 7. Ball's way high snap. They give it off up the middle. Lee's got it bottled up. Looks like the whole line was there waiting for him.
Yep.
On the carry for the line was number 3, Terrell Prayer. Stopped by 62, Will Ratboat. Be 3rd and 9 for the line.
Looks like we got Marley at corner. Deal at the other corner. Ferrassi at free safety. Outside linebackers going to be Lindley and Dunn. Spinks at their middle. We'll come back and give the rest of the defensive line in a second.
Handoff up the middle, and we were ready for that one. That's going to bring up, looks like, 4th down. Yeah. I imagine they'll be getting in punt formation.
Okay.
That was number 3, Terrell Prayer.
Looks like the defensive line is
down by 54, Harris Stone Street.
Stone Street, Lively, Rybolt, and Meredith, Lane as well.
Okay.
Be 4th and 13 for Delta Street line.
It looks like Marley may be the one. Are they going for it?
They're spread out. I don't see a punter.
They're going for it.
Okay.
That's interesting.
Quarterback running, pass to the flat, and I think the quarterback and the receiver were not on the same page on that one.
Not very smart to go for it. I guess I don't know what they're thinking on that.
I don't know. It gives the Colts a short field, but, yeah, the receiver kind of broke out, and the quarterback looked like he was expecting him to cut up to the inside, and that's where he threw it, and nobody was there.
But going for it on 4th and 12 on your own 15 is usually not a good thing to do.
No. Well, again, given the Colt offense a very, very good starting field position. Ferrassi's under the center. Hand off up the middle.
To Spinks.
And it looks like he's going to get it in.
Yep.
And they weren't stopping him.
They're not going to get him.
Touchdown, number 9.
That's a fast start for the Lee Colts.
Ian Spinks, Lee Academy Colts.
Well, I hope we keep this pace up. We may have an early night.
And get a little running clock. I believe our junior varsity is undefeated on the year. Is that true?
They are undefeated.
That's impressive. And they're going to line up to go for two. Frassie hands off.
To Spinks again, and he will get in.
Yeah, he's going to barrel his way in.
He didn't have the greatest hole there, but he made his own hole.
He did. He just put his head down and kept turning those feet, moving forward, and got across the goal line.
All right.
We'll stay here and wait the kickoff.
Yep. We apologize. We're probably not going to be running any ads tonight because, frankly, me and Quincy don't know how to do it. And
we're good.
We'll have to get you back Friday.
I hit plus six. I'm trying to get the scoreboard working, guys.
I think you got
to
click it on the mouse.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Do the six and then the two.
Where's the?
Just click.
Got it.
Oops.
Oh, shoot.
Go down. Go hit the minus button.
All right, I got it. I'm trying to figure.
Just go up one. I think we got
it. There we go.
There we go. Perfect.
Learning the system here. Bobby does so much, probably very underappreciated all that he does.
Kicking off of the academy will be number 7, Noah Lindley.
Noah's ready to set to kick again. Better kick this time. Taken across the 20. Stutter stepping. Got the outside, going to get taken down there. It looks like about the 26, 27-yard line.
Looks like it. Hayden Keenum on the tackle.
First and 10, down the straight line.
It was a good defensive first series. Let's see if they can keep it up this second series.
Yeah, I don't think they got negative yards last time, so.
Delta Streets coming to the line.
The same two receiver set that they've been running.
Hand off up the middle. Oh, got him. Got him. Got him by his shirt tail, and the other guy stood him up.
Yep.
I couldn't see the number.
That wasn't going anywhere. Looks like a lane maybe in there, 52.
That was number 10, Thomas on the carry.
But I'm looking through this smaller screen, so it's harder to tell.
I'm seeing it right here. And when they get jumbled in, it's hard to see who the number. Ball's away. He's running to
he's
near
not
side.
Even trying to pass.
No, he's trying to get some. We got a flag on the play.
A holding, probably.
Probably. A little laundry on the field.
There's a flag on the play.
And considering how they've been moving, I'd just go ahead and back them up anyway.
That's right.
I'll give them extra down. Just
got two flags on the play. I wonder if they saw the same thing.
Let's see what Clint's got. Hold.
Holding Delta Street line.
And we accepted the penalty. Well, they're going in the wrong direction. I don't think they've really got much positive yardage yet.
No, I think it's second and 22, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
Be second and 22 for the Lions.
Quarterback is in the shotgun. Gets the snap.
And that is going nowhere.
The defensive line is ready for him up the middle tonight.
It's just a whole host of kids in there. Probably look like Spinks and
down by a host of the academy.
Maybe Lively, maybe Stone Street. I
think
there's,
they all had
a bunch
a hand
of,
in
there's
there.
A bunch of them.
Again, it was going nowhere. Ringing up third and forever.
The third 22 lines.
You always liked playing teams that didn't like to block me.
Yes, that made the game a lot of fun on the defensive side of the ball. Got a shotgun, running
right here.
And throwing it out. He's got a man and off, nope. Just off his fingers. Incomplete.
Let's see if they'll go for it on fourth and forever.
Pressure on number 62, Will Ryboat.
Deep in their own territory.
I wonder if they have a punter that maybe why they just go for it.
Or not. I believe this is Delta Street's first year playing. Mm-hmm. Is that correct?
Junior, I have no idea. They've definitely had a high school team for a while.
Okay.
I'm assuming they've had a junior high team for a while as well. But they appear to be going for it, which –
that might just be their MO tonight. Just keep going. Work on their offense.
I don't think there's a fourth and whatever.
Are they switching up? Quarterback is not direct snap. Oh, they were going to punt.
Looks like he was going to punt, but
and
then
didn't have time. Defense was all over him.
Brought down by a host of Lee Academy coach.
Well, this game looks like it may get ugly quick. They're setting us up. We're not going to have to go very far.
No, which, you know, we get into that running clock, get some of our younger players some good playing time, some good experience out there, help them out as well.
Be first and 10, Lee Academy.
They're running a three-man front.
Man in motion. Handoff up the middle. No, they got confused me to the outside and taken down for a loss is but a little flag on the play.
Yeah, in the middle
that was Andrew Yang on the carry.
The middle was wide open.
It was.
Andrew Yang on the carry.
When I saw it going up the middle, that's where I thought it was. That's where the hole was.
It was wide open. But
flag on the play.
The defense stretched it out and got him down quick, but we do have some laundry on the field.
I don't know what the call is going
to
be.
Waiting to see what Clint says.
That's a face mask
on them.
Delta Streets.
Well, I don't know if it could get much worse for Delta Streets. They just they finally made a stop.
And they did.
And then messed it up.
Defense did a good job of stringing it out and being there, but apparently got some of the face mask and bringing him down on the tackle.
It was the 5-yard variety, so it must not have been too bad.
Max under center. Oh, fumble. Picks it up, and defense is right there to stop him.
Fumble on the play.
Now, we had a bunch of bad snaps. I think Washington, we had about 7 fumbles from under center, so hopefully we can get that cleared up.
Well, this is a good game to do that in, the way it's shaping up. Max back under center. Hand off up the middle, and there
he
is
just
going
to walk
in.
I really think that every time we get the ball, if we just hand it to Wynn, I don't know. They're lining up in a three-man front, and it's just wide open.
I agree. They may not get out of it. They may make an adjustment. I don't know, but you still want to work on some other things. Line it up for the 2-point try. Grassy's back under center.
Still on a 3-man front. They are blitzing some people, but still.
Out to the outside a little bit. Wide open for Andrew Yang.
Is good. That was number 2, Andrew Yang.
Well.
We'll keep it here and listen to the awesome tunes that our speaker queen plays for us.
Is that your bride that's playing
is.
Tunes?
It is. We've got some good ones queued up for varsity as well.
Okay.
Players, little red wine, when Sean Redwine does something. You know, we got a few queued up and ready to go.
Number 7, Noah Lindley. Back back deep for the Lions is number 10, Thomas.
All right, Noah's getting ready to set to kick it away. Kicks up the middle, a little squib, fielded. He's making his way up the field. Gets better starting position for them. Looks like they almost got up to about the 44-yard line.
Yeah, it looks like they were wanting 10 to get it, and he got it. So.
And made a good little run there for them.
He's got to, is 10 their quarterback?
I think he's one of their one of their taller receivers.
Okay.
That two receiver set they gave.
That's a straight line.
But they hadn't got him the ball yet.
I think they direct snapped at him. He thought about punting on that last play.
That's, okay.
Yeah, the quarterback, I'm trying to remember his number, but he's a little bit shorter.
Okay.
Might be him number two coming in there after he got the play.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think two may be the quarterback.
Mm-hmm.
10 is the tailback.
Lined up. Quarterback's got it. He's running. And we're on him. We got
and
a flag.
That's going to be holding.
All right, don't hit out of bounds. Good job. It's a way to let up.
That's number two, Applewhite for Death of Street Lions. Pushed out of bounds by number nine, Wynn Spink.
Wynn was on him from the get-go.
Flag yeah. on the play.
Well, apparently they didn't hold enough because there wasn't.
Maybe he's not the one that got held. I didn't see.
I don't know.
Because it looked like he was untouched. Looks like Wynn's got a pretty good nose for the ball and just took off for it, and he was there.
Holding against the line.
I mean, usually when you hold, you get some yardage, so they're holding and not getting anything.
Yeah, our defense is playing solid right now. All right, Delta Street's going to try to regroup, come up with something, get them some yardage here. Try to move the football.
We just need to stay in the game and not try to, you know,
right.
not think they can't do anything.
That's right. Toss to number 10. Around the outside, he's got a little room. Good hard run. I think he is close to the first down.
No, that is the line of scrimmage. That's the original
line of scrimmage. So. He got the holding penalty back.
Yeah, but it was one of their first plays that actually got some yardage.
John Logan Deal.
That's what I was talking about. We just don't need to fall asleep out here thinking they can't get any yardage.
Right, that will rile a coach up quicker than anything.
Because they do, I mean, they have some speed.
Second and 10 for Delta Street Line.
It looks like Dunn is coming out.
All right, Stratton.
Tens get it again.
And cut back to the middle.
And not a whole lot. The ball came out, but it looks like they had blown it dead.
Yeah, I think he may have picked up about 4 yards,
four or five. So it's going to be
third and about five?
Looks like six.
Third and six, okay.
But this is the closest they've been to converting yet.
So a first down, yeah.
We'll see if they can get a first down here.
Well, it's the first time they started outside the shadow of their goalpost there.
Yeah. We got 2:25 left in the first quarter. Colts up 16-0.
Quarterback takes shotgun snap, handoff, and we were there that time. Nowhere to go.
I don't know who hit him, but he hit him as soon as he got the ball. It may have been. I can't tell who that was.
52, Lane
okay, it was Wilkerson.
Well, Lane was in the backfield about the time the ball got there.
I thought I saw a 50-something. I wasn't sure which one of our 50s it was.
That's right. But, again, I mean, as soon as the running back got the ball, he was there.
Because all three of our defensive linemen, Lively, Stone Street, and Wilkerson all have 50-something.
Yeah. Well, they are lining up to go forward on fourth yet again.
Yeah, well, I guess I just don't think they have a punter is be my guess. And that's
short
not
throw.
And at least throw it past the marker.
That wasn't even – that was behind the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, so I don't know.
That's a young team. Give them a little time to go. We'll see what happens. But it's a young football team. They're out here battling.
Yeah, they got a long way to go.
Max is bringing him to the line. Looks like we're going back under center. Man in motion, gives to him.
That's going to be Yang, and
he's got a little room to the outside. Good tackle there by number 10, their tailback.
Yeah. He's still got about seven, 8 yards.
Number 10.
Looks like he got past the 30, so I think that's 8.
Yeah, that's about what it looked like. You know, that's good first down yardage.
Maybe it looks like it's closer to 9, actually, is okay. Where they're marking it. So, yeah, I mean, a good run.
Good tackle for them, too.
Well, if they're tackling 9 yards down the field, that's fine. We'll
that's a
it.
Recipe for success for the Colts, no doubt. Hand off to Andrew Yang. Cuts up, makes cuts good, cut up the lane. That'll be the first down yardage.
Yep.
That's number 2, Andrew Yang, on the carry for the Academy. Brought down by number 10, DeFuan
Thomas.
We got
43 seconds left to go in
the
quarter.
Back up under center, get Yang, and looks like straight in the backfield. 14 in motion. All right, we got a pass play. Open, caught, cut up, good cut back, good run after catch.
It looks like 14.
Graydon Burke.
Burke, yeah.
Number 14, that's Graydon Burke.
And that looks
down by
close to a
nine,
first down. Maybe,
Johnson.
Maybe just short. Imagine we're going to give it to Spinks here.
Would not be a bad play call.
He may score, I mean.
Man in motion. Oh, they're ready for him that time. Oh.
No, that was to Yang. And
but another penalty. I didn't see the face mask on that one.
But it looks like from where they called it, it looks like it may have been a face mask, but I didn't see it.
I didn't see it either. If it is, it might be that 5 yard variety.
Looks like
again.
The.
I didn't see a hold, but.
Yep.
Oh, personal foul.
Well, I guess they can't tackle us unless they're grabbing the face mask. So. But we'll take it. We'll just keep on marching down the field, get a little closer. Looks like we're on about the 5 or 6.
Frassie back under center. Up the middle.
And they just cannot get Spinks down. He drugs. Three guys. They had him. They had him in the backfield. He just kept dragging them.
Yeah, keep those feet moving. That's what they've been taught. That should probably bring us to the end of the first quarter.
Yep. But again, no ads. We're just going to leave it here.
That's right. You're stuck with us tonight.
Unfortunately.
Yes. I'm sure everybody's missing Bobby right about now.
Yeah. I'll get some of the cheerleaders here.
There you go. It is a beautiful night for a football game.
Yeah. Hopefully we'll get some cooler weather coming in the next couple of weeks.
Well, I think Thursday we're supposed to get that rain front. It's probably while they reschedule the game. I think it's supposed to have a little cool front come through after that.
So Friday's going to be cool, huh?
I think I saw something where the lows will be in the 40s, highs in the 70s.
And I think we're playing at Rawson Friday night.
Okay.
And then I think there's the junior high maybe has one more game. High school will have two more after Friday.
I think that is correct.
Of course, we're going to hope for some playoff activities.
Exactly. I know the junior high is undefeated. Varsity, I think, have we lost a district game?
Well, we've only played one, so no, we're 1-0.
Okay, that.
But you can't get any better than that.
That's right. In the district, that is correct. Man in motion. Up the middle, and they're not stopping him. That's touchdown,
well,
Spinks.
The ball came out, but I guess he.
Number 9,
I guess he had already crossed the plane.
I think so.
But they're not wanting to tackle Wynn.
He's hitting it hard. And when there's not a hole, like you said earlier, he made his own.
Yeah.
Colts going to line up and go for two again. Another Spinks again, and they're going to get it for two.
PAT is good. That's number nine. Win Spinks.
Colts lead 24-0 over Delta Streets Academy.
It's kind of reminding me of like when I played Tecmo Bowl back in the day, and I just kept on running Walter Payton up the middle. And
eventually it takes
over. They just couldn't stop him.
That would have been good. Me and you played, I'd have taken Bo Jackson. And it looked like that LSU-Ole Miss game. Nobody could stop each other.
Yeah, I can't remember if Tecmo Bowl had – was Bo in the first one? I think he was in the first one.
I can't remember. I had the Nintendo. I had a buddy that had the Tecmo Bowl game and it played over there. But I know Bo was very hard to tackle in that game.
I can't remember if it was the first game or the second game. Twenty-four to nothing. 7:55 left in the first half.
And Noah's getting ready to kick back off. He's been one of the busier Colts tonight.
Yep.
Kicking off for Lee Academy, be number 7, Noah Lindley.
And right down the middle, gets past everybody.
They got to get it. I mean,
here they go.
He's gonna fumble it again.
I think he left it for number 10 to pick up.
I don't know that they wanted it.
They did not. He's like, here, put it on the ground. Like, that's a live ball.
You get it.
Brought down by 28, John Logan Deal
on the tackle. We got the ball right at the 20.
What's the threshold again? 30? Is it 36?
35. 35 is the when the running clock will start.
Okay.
All right, here comes Delta Streets to the line. Colt defense lining up and getting ready.
They got 10 as a receiver this time.
Yeah, I saw him been that two receiver set earlier, but he has run the ball a few times. High snap, got it number 24. He's trying to get the edge, but got brought down.
It looks like Rybolt, 62.
Got him down.
24, Trevor Roach on the carry. Brought down by 56, Jackson Lively.
Or Jackson Lively got him. I couldn't see again all those 50-somethings. But loss on the play. Good job, Lee Academy defense.
Yep. Our defensive line is making a lot of plays tonight.
Yes, they are, which is a good thing. You don't want your safeties and your cornerbacks having to be making the tackles. Shotgun. Here comes quarterback keeper, and he is going nowhere.
Looks like Wilkerson got to him again. I don't think they're blocking. Oh, no, that may have been – no, that was Lively, I think.
I noticed that ball's taking a little bit to get to there from the center of the quarterback. It's taking a second. It's not there quick, which is giving our defensive line a little extra time to get to them. It's just not a quick snap. It's kind of a slower snap to the quarterback. All right, got two receivers near side. Oh, there's that late snap. Here, they're going downfield. That's pick off.
That's picked off by
Max Ferrassi. And taken down.
About four or five.
Yep. So be Colt offense.
That's intercepted by number 3, Max Ferrassi. Be 1st and 10, Lee Academy coach.
He was just throwing that, trying to get it somewhere downfield, and didn't get much on it, and he was just sitting there waiting on it.
Yeah, it was not a good throw.
First and goal.
All right, Prassie under center. And off the ladder, they're waiting on him that time.
They finally tackled him.
They were waiting on him that time.
Number 9, Wynn Spinks on the carry for the Academy. Brought down by number 7, Jones.
Well, I guess we may have to run to different plays. You know,
or same play, different side.
Number 7, Ahmad Jones.
They finally figured that one out.
If they get over-aggressive one way, what does Bob always say?
Run the counter. The counter. I don't know.
Yeah, they went to the outside. Tim was there. Not much going for Andrew Yang on that one.
He's still got to about the 3, I think.
Brought down by number 10, Jaquan Thomas.
So we're going to be in 4 down territory as well.
Oh, there's no doubt.
I mean, we got 2 plays here.
There you go.
Max directing traffic, getting everybody set where he wants them. Man in
this
motion. This
left side outside is wide open.
Oh, and they just ran it right there.
Right there.
No doubt.
Number 9,
got people out there blocking, and that one was easy.
They looked like they were sending everybody in the middle, and that left side was just wide open.
With an extra blocker.
Yeah.
That made it easy. That's no score.
It's 30-0.
With the 2-point try coming.
Gonna be just
keeper. He kept it and keeper. Oh, ooh. I think they stopped him. Good
yeah.
hit. Good D.
Is good.
Oh, he did get it in.
No, it's no good. He's saying no good.
I thought I saw the ref signal good on the far side, but he looked short to me.
The head ref, I think, said no good.
It did not look good from my point of view.
Well, we would have had to get another touchdown anyway to get the clock rolling, so that's not the end of the world.
No.
But I do think we'll have the clock running before halftime.
If the game is going like it has been, I would agree with you on that one.
Our only enemy is we have 4:47 if for some reason they could run it out.
Well, I mean, there's not a lot of pass plays they're doing. It's a lot of runs. So.
And the ones they are, they're just throwing it up. But we still got timeouts, I guess, if we wanted to use them.
True. Noah, I know his leg was hurt. It's getting a workout tonight.
Yeah.
I hope he's it seems like he's good to go, but don't want to protect that leg. But he is definitely getting a workout with it tonight with kickoff duties.
Well, surely we got somebody that could at least just kick an onside kick even.
That's right. Noah will be going to varsity. Good kick taken. About the 25, by number 10, and met right there.
Looked like Yang.
And Hayden Keenum, I think.
Yep, Hayden Keenum.
Brought down by number 18, Hayden Keenum.
Again, that's some of their better starting field position. Taking their time getting the play in.
Well, their bus didn't get here until about game time.
It was close.
Very close.
About 6:40, 6:45, we saw them pull in. Got confusion, a new quarterback in the game, and that probably be a timeout. Yes, timeout, Delta Streets.
Time out on the field.
Looks like they're trying a new quarterback.
Well, we'll see. I mean, if he was that good, I guess he would have been starting. So I don't know who
It is.
How good he is.
That number two they had, he looks very, very quick. Very fast, and I think they're not really a throwing team yet. They're trying to run and use him. But
and the throws they did have, there was somebody in his face every time. So I don't know if he can throw it or not. But
well, he's also not the tallest, so he's got to get it over him.
They've got a real small roster.
Yeah, I think we counted 17, 18 players.
Yeah, they've only
– on their junior high team.
They don't have a whole lot on the sideline.
All right, out of the timeout. It looks like it's 24. Looked like he's going to be the quarterback.
And he still looks confused. I don't
– right. Yep, shotgun, quicker snap that time. But oh, right there. Oh, yes. Nowhere to go.
Yeah, he had four guys on him
quickly.
Yeah. Trevor Roach on the carry.
So, again, not a lot of blocking.
Noah Lindley in there on it, too.
It's just a massive
somebody
screen.
Got the initial hit, and then there was three or four more right there ready to go. And here comes number 10 from the sideline. Play call.
Looks like I think 10 and maybe 7 are the two better athletes. If they could, 10 may just take the snap this time.
It very well may be. Oh, botched
snap. Bad snap.
And
though.
We're right there to cover it.
I think Wilkerson hit him first, and then
Wynn got him down.
But yeah, Wynn got him down. Brought down by number 9, Wynn Spink. Third and 17.
Coach giving number 10 the play and bringing it to the huddle. Come to the line. Looks like 10's going to take the snap again. And he's going to take off running and nowhere to go. Oh, spins out of it. Yeah. Good. That was a good hard run by number 10. But we were just there.
Still didn't. Barely got back to the line of scrimmage, I think.
Right.
Number 10, Daquan Thomas on the carry.
Thought we should have had him wrapped up a couple yards behind, but he made a nice spin move.
And that's going to be fourth down again, and I assume they'll go for it again and
probably
give us good field position again, hopefully, if we don't. They've got to pull out a fourth, and that looks – the scoreboard says fourth and 17, but – that looks like fourth and 22.
At least, yeah. It's fourth
longer,
and forever.
It's definitely longer than 17.
It's longer than any offensive play they have ran tonight.
They have not gotten 22 yards in a single play. I don't know if they got 22 yards all night, period.
Yeah, they've had some negative possessions. All right, here we go.
He's going to throw it.
And it's up and picked
another
again.
Pick.
And they're right there to tackle him.
And we probably should have knocked it down because we'd have got the ball at the 20. Instead, it's basically like a punt there.
Yeah.
But I can't blame him. It's fun to get interceptions.
That's right.
I
pad those stats. Good job, Mr. Deal.
Yeah. I would have tried to catch it, too.
Well, shoot, a chance to score a touchdown if you get the pick,
yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
You get to play offense.
Yeah, if I was – I actually – when I was in high school, picked and ran one back, and I was not going to stop. Because you don't, as a lineman, you don't get any chances.
No,
like that.
I thought the same thing when I did it, and I thought wrong. I was stopped.
And there's that counter, and it looks wide open.
And if we can get to the outside,
no, I think they're going to get to him. But it was a good play call. It was open.
Number 14, Graydon Burke on the carry for Lee Academy.
Nice run by Graydon.
By number 7, Jones.
Just Jones. Huh?
I think Hal has a little pronunciation issues from time to time. All right, Mike's under center, got him at the line, ready to go.
That's going to be a pass.
Wide open. Deal.
Oh, there, Deal, they rewarded him for the pick.
Yes, they did. Did not take long for him to get into that end
zone. And I think that's going to be the 36 threshold. So let's run clock run. But they don't seem to be running it.
I don't know why, but, you know. There he goes. Clint is giving the signal to run the clock.
Okay.
I just saw him
blow
the whistle
and
do the wind-up motion. Oh, that might be offsides, they call it. But he's going to squeak through anyway.
Perhaps he gets in.
That puts it 38-0, Lee Academy Colts.
And this first half is fixing to be over very quickly here. We may get the kickoff off, and that's about it.
Yep. And I think we deferred, so we'll get the ball to start the second half.
Yeah, I would look for some younger players probably coming in the game.
Absolutely. Get them some experience.
And I think
game time experience is
we're
probably like it.
We probably got some boys going to be playing high school, so we're not going to see probably several of them after the halftime.
And that gives, again, a whole half for the younger guys to get in there and get some game experience. That will benefit them down the road.
Yep, we didn't even have to kick it off.
All right, we are at halftime. We're going to the mic on.
I'm going to put my mic in the window so y'all can hear the festivities, and I'm going to leave the camera where y'all can see the cheerleaders there. And
we will catch up with y'all after the halftime.
All righty.
Okay, let's welcome the Lee Academy Junior High cheerleaders.
Thank you.
Welcome back after halftime. Looks like we got about a minute before we start the second half. Colts will receive the ball to start the second half. Up right now 38 to nothing.
With a running clock.
It'll probably be a pretty quick half.
Yes.
The the streets huddling up, coming over, getting ready for their second half plans. Looks like Lee Academy's getting on the field, getting ready to receive the kick. Looks like Hayden Keenum and Andrew Yang back deep to receive.
And I don't think we've seen them kick yet.
We have not seen them kick yet. And
we don't know what they might do.
It does not look like he's even using a tee.
It looks like, yeah, he's going to be an onside. So we need to come up. I don't know what.
Again, no tee. The ball's laying flat on the ground.
Yang and Keenum need to come up because it is not going to get to them. Unless he's like a really good kicker.
All right, here they go. We're getting ready to start second half. And it is onside, and we've fallen on it. Is that Noah?
That's Noah.
Noah fell on it quickly. Lee Academy offense coming on the field.
Noah Lindley, be first and 10. Lee Academy coach.
All right, let's take a look and see if we have any new faces out there.
It looks to me just about all new. I see a lot of our starters on the sidelines. I see Meredith running in.
Yep.
I assume Meredith's going to be the quarterback. I'm assuming it's going to be a full B team. Yeah, it looks like a full B team. Yang is still in there because he is on the B team, actually.
All right. Graydon's under center. Handoff up the middle. Keenum. Little stutter step, and they were kind of expecting that. Gain of one.
Yeah, looks like we can call some names out here. That looks like Hunter Marley coming in. I don't know.
It is. It looks like Yang. Is that? No, 18.
Looks like Keenum's coming out.
Keenum coming out. There goes Graydon back in with the play.
So your backfield is going to be Marley and Yang. Looks like Burton is going to be tight end. 44 is
Maddox Presley.
Yeah, Presley.
Oh, ball's on the ground. He fell on it.
Yeah.
Good ball awareness by Graydon there to follow on it.
Looks like the line is Behringer. Let's see who that is. Burleson, most likely.
Yeah, Graydon Burleson.
I'm thinking Walls maybe out there is 70. I think he's the center. Looks like Lawrence is going to be the receiver.
All right, up the middle run, sneaking through. Oh, they got a hand on him and got him down behind.
That was Marley on that carry.
Yep.
That's number 51. Hunter Marley on the carry for Lee Academy.
And I don't know.
Brought down by number 7,
all right.
Jones.
Who is 60, I think, is Sawyer and TC.
Be fourth and 10, Lee Academy.
Let's see who else is out there. 70 is Walls. I think that's Walls. 72? I don't know who 72 is.
Jacob Payton.
Okay, so that's going to be all the starters that are out there.
Wesley Lawrence on the outside receiving, and here comes Graydon to throw, pump, and then kind of throws deep, and
in and out of his hands.
Defender's hands. We had wide open there. It was number 22.
Yeah, that's Burton.
For number 22, Patrick Burton.
I don't know if it was intended for him or not, but it did hit his hands.
Yeah, it went right through the defender's hands. It was a little underthrown because he was back there. I like the play call there. Give us a chance to make that first down.
Was that a fourth down play?
I believe it was.
Well, this is the first time they've had the ball past the 50 tonight. So, and I don't think they even if they wanted to put subs in, I don't know that they have a ton of subs. I do see looks like 10s on the sideline.
Okay. Number 2's back in, bottle snap, and they pick it back up.
He did get it.
Oh, he's still on his feet.
Burton had him.
There it is.
And Maddox.
Presley.
Maddox. I get all the Presley boys confused in my head, but that was Maddox.
There you go, good tackle. He snuck away from somebody, but we got him wrapped up. Again, the center quarterback exchange, they're having a little trouble with, it looks like, tonight.
They've had a lot of trouble with almost every aspect.
Yeah, happens with a young team. And I think our JV's pretty good this year.
Yeah.
All right, number two in the shotgun, Delta Streets. A little high snap again, takes off running, got a little crease.
Let's see Marley chasing him. Marley's going to get him. Looks That's like Hunter Marley.
Two, Hunter got to make the tackle.
Brought down by 51, Hunter Marley.
It's going to be third and about eight.
All right, here comes.
Let's give our cheerleaders a hand, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, here comes number two back in with the play call, giving it to his teammates. Number 11 into the game for Delta Streets. He looks excited to play.
Yeah, I think that he hadn't been in the game yet.
Right, he is excited to be out there. Here comes the quarterback keeper. Good cutback.
And it's still not enough for the first, but
no,
he is.
I imagine,
and they're going to go for it.
They hadn't punted yet tonight.
No, and they've gone for it with fourth and a lot longer, so they'll definitely go for this. This is fourth and manageable, fourth and like
three.
Fourth and three on our side of the field, which is unusual.
But we're almost off out of the third quarter, 2 minutes left.
What is going on here? What is this? Later?
Yeah, I would say later.
All right, we're back up. Hand off to number three. Jumps the guy. Oh, we're there.
He
made it. He
breaks away.
And he may go the distance. He is going to go the distance.
Come on, Marley.
Good effort, but a lot of speed right there.
Well, good for them.
They got a score, earned score.
Nobody likes to come out here and play and not get any points on the board.
Nope. Here comes number 10, Blake Martin, into the game. Try to stop the two-point try.
It's unfortunate. We actually had him in the backfield a couple times and just let him go.
Pretty quick. And let's give them a score here. All right, huddling up.
And I think this is going to be the last of the third quarter.
I would agree. Number two in the shotgun takes the snap. Hand off the backside. And we're just missing some tackles, but we got him down. 51.
There's Marley again. He made that one.
Yes, he did.
He ain't kidding, no good.
24 spiked it down.
All right.
And that is 15 seconds. And that's going to run out the third quarter.
Yeah, there's no way they'll get ready to kick off before that runs out. I like these nights where we don't have to wait for that sun to go down. It was already there.
Yeah, it's nice.
Not too hot, not too cold, just a great night for some football.
Well, it's actually fourth quarter now.
It is now fourth, okay. I just changed it to third a second ago.
Yeah. Yeah. I got it. Yeah, I got it.
Bobby may be listening and critiquing us on our
Granted, the third quarter did not last very long.
No.
So
I think it was halfway through when I changed it from the second quarter to the third quarter, and then it was over.
And it's already ticking down in the fourth. So.
All right, Delta Streets, again, ball on the ground.
We
no
need
tee.
To come up. Come on up, guys. Come on up. They are not going to kick it that deep. I don't know why you're that deep.
Just following it. Number three got it.
It's Farassi.
Yep. And that probably be his limited action in the second half.
Yeah, I would think so.
Blake Martin back in the game on the offense side. Graydon Meredith getting them together, getting the play call in. And here they come to the line. Are we missing? How many players we got out there?
The receiver needs to get to the other side there. Come on.
Passes away, grading the pass.
And the receiver's not there, I don't think. Well, no, he.
Oh, just hit him in the hand.
Burton again.
Patrick Burton. Yep. He had to reach it, got one hand on it, and that's all he could do.
Yeah, I think the receiver was supposed to line up on the other side on that last play.
All right, here
he's still lining up on the wrong side.
All right.
Come on. Blake. There we go. He's going now.
All right, Blake's to the other side. Might be the same. Oh.
Just run it.
Oh, man. Wow. Lowered that shoulder and got the first down.
That
wow.
Was, it's worth coming just to see that. He ran slap over that guy.
I heard that up here. That was good pad knocking right there.
And that was for a first down.
It was.
Jaquan Applewhite.
That guy better come with a little more than that next time.
Looks like Wesley Lawrence into the game as well for the Colts. Comes Blake to the sideline. Right up the gut.
Middle to Marley.
Oh, and he just couldn't keep his feet, but he got some part of positive yardage out of that.
And number 51, Hunter Marley on the carry for Lee Academy, broke down by number 24, Trevor Roach.
And he got about five yards.
Yeah, so it looks like about 5 yards. That's good first down yardage.
Good pickup.
Could have been more if he could have caught his feet under him.
We're at 420.
Up the middle again. Good cut back, but the defender was there.
Yep.
Oh, took him down hard.
But they'll give him a little bit of forward progress there. So he's probably just a couple yards short.
Brought down by number 45, yep. Jalen Hoover.
And I'm sure we'll be in fourth. Yeah. I mean, we'll go for it on fourth down.
We should. I think it's third and a long two is what it looks like.
So, and the clock is running quick.
Third and two, Lee Academy.
But, yeah, I agree with you. Definitely four down territory, two plays. Graydon, handoff.
To Yang, and it looks like there's a hole there. I don't know if
he got
it or not.
I think he did by where the official spotted it. He did.
As number two, Andrew Yang on the carry for Lee Academy.
That first down is just about going to run out the game because we're going to keep running it, and we're right at 325. So it's –
at this point, run past, the clock's still running. So
yeah.
we can open up the playbook for the young ones, let them have some fun. And they're grading on the keeper, and we got some blockers out there.
And I don't think they want to hard tackle.
He didn't lower his shoulder on that one.
They were doing some old laying out there. they drug him down from behind, but they didn't want to get in front of him. I know that.
Right.
Not after they saw their buddy.
Go backwards. Oh, glad that was not me. All right. Graydon's under center. Up the gut.
Marley.
Wrapped him up. Short gain.
Got
if any.
About to the five, maybe.
Number 51, Hunter Marley on the carry, brought down by number 24, Trevor
Be nice to at least get the young guys to get it in the end zone.
That's right. Well, Hunter's behind him, waiting on the ball.
Looks like gets Marley in, again.
Dancing a little bit. Gets down to about the two or three.
Yeah.
Number 51, Hunter Marley on the carry.
Bring it up third down.
Brought down by number 3, Terrell Prayer.
Looks like they spotted it about the 3.
Again, 2 plays to get it in.
Yep.
Think a little something to their keying on that inside move, maybe a little something to the outside. Yeah, up the middle again.
He spun and almost.
He fought far, but they blew the whistle for him. Yeah, that
but
last
he got
effort.
It back to the 1.
And
we're
at
1:20 left.
At this point, I think coach is just saying we're going to give it in his hands and try to get it and punch it in the end zone.
Either way, it's probably going to be about the end of the game.
There we are. Oh, bubble snap. Oh. Either way, I think it'll be their ball.
Yeah, he picked it up, but he would have had to score, so he didn't score. But I don't even know if they'll have enough time to even snap a play.
Sure. Stanley Dotson entering the game on defense.
Jackson Webb's asking who's broadcasting. That is Mr. Quincy beside me, Jackson.
Well, I don't know if it's just me. It's both of us, Richard, I think.
Well, he knew me. I think he was asking. He didn't recognize your voice, I guess.
All right. They're lining up. Shotgun. Trying to get it out of their end zone. They do and get a little yardage.
He just runs out of bounds, and that's going to end the game.
Congratulations, Lee Academy Colts. 38-6 for the Lee Academy Junior Varsity. Thank you for tuning in tonight. Again, apologize for the lack of advertisements, but we'll be back extra hard with them next week. Good night, Colt Nation, and hotty toddy.
Hail State.
We do both of them. We're not playing each other this week.